Hello friends, welcome to my channel, myself Parag Dabholkar. In last video, we have seen what is inheritance and also we have seen different types of inheritance. So basically there are these five types of inheritance: single inheritance, multi-level inheritance, multiple inheritance, hierarchical inheritance and hybrid inheritance. Now see, this is class A and this class A is getting inherited in class B. So here we call this class A as a parent class or the base class or super class. Parent class, base class or super class. While this class B is called as child class or derived class or subclass. Here variables and functions are there, and these variables and functions, they have this access specifier. It might be private or protected or public. When we are inheriting these variables and functions to another class, so they will have there some access specifier. Suppose any variable, it has public access specifier. So after coming to class B, it will have some another access specifier. So who will decide what is the access specifier of the variables and functions those are inherited to class B? So it is decided by this visibility mode. So how this visibility mode affect this access specifier of variables and functions? So it will get clear by this table. Now look at this. So these are the access specifier of base class or parent class, and these are the visibility modes. So access specifier can be private, protected and public, and these are the access specifier of base class. And suppose this visibility modes, it can be private, protected or public. Now see, after passing those elements, passing variables and functions to the derived class or child class, what will be the access specifier? It can be seen from this table. So these are the access specifier of derived class or child class. So members, here you can see private members of base class. So as it is a private, those are not accessible in derived classes, and that's why it is written any. Any means not accessible. Private members of base class, so whatever it is the visibility mode, those are not accessible in derived class. Now see, those are the protected members of base class. If visibility mode is private, so they becomes private in derived class. If visibility mode is protected, so protected members of base class becomes protected members of derived class. So they remain protected. If access specifier of this variables and function in base class is protected, and if visibility mode is public, so they remain protected only. Now see, if access specifier is public, so after passing, after inheriting to derived class, if visibility mode is private, so public members becomes private. If visibility mode is protected, so this public members becomes protected members of derived class. And if visibility mode is public, so this public members of base class remain public in derived class. So here you can see, this is a class A. So here we can have one private member, we can have protected members, we can have public members, and in this case we have one function. We are inheriting to class B, and this class B has its own private members, protected members and public members. Now see, when we are inheriting, so these members are accessible or they get passed to class B. This means these members, these variables and function becomes part of class B also, or derived class. So when we create object of this derived class, so from this class, from this object, we can access functions of B class, also parent class is A class. So see here, Bisho is a function of derived class, so that also we can access, and we can also access the function of parent class, and in the same way we can also access the variables. These are the access specifier of this class, parent class, and after passing to this class, what will be their access specifier is decided by this table. So friends, I hope you like this video. If yes, click on like, subscribe to this channel, and don't forget to press bell icon so that you will get notification of my next video. So stay connected. Thank you.